Never be fearful of what you are doing if it's right. What's your superpower? Welcome to Patriot News. Today is Tuesday, March 16th, and it's Women's History Month, as you all know, and there are 33 days until the start of the PSSA testing.
Before we get into that, we have our new co-host, Mrs. Bear. She's sitting here sleeping, if you will.
Hey, that's personification.
Exactly. Speaking of personification, here's our PSSA word of the day, personification. It defines as an object or abstract idea given human qualities or human form.
Next week on March 22nd, make sure to wear bright colors to celebrate the welcoming of spring.
As you can see, I'm a bit early.
I want to give a big thank you to everyone who wore purple this week. You all looked great. Run that clip. Project. Reminder to all staff and scholars, the First Female Project is underway. We will stop accepting video submissions this Friday at the end of the day. This is a video collage project.
We are asking our scholars and staff members to record and submit a 30-second video where they reference a female who was the first to do something in American history. Videos should include the woman's name, accomplishment, and why you selected them. Videos are to be submitted via Flipgrid. Let's take a look at our very first submission provided by our very own Mrs. Hill.
Hey, Penwood Middle School, it's Mrs. Hill here to tell you about something special we will be doing for March 2021 to celebrate Women's History Month. We will be doing a special segment called First Females, where each and every one of you, as well as our staff, will be able to choose a first female to honor this month. I will start by saying that I was the first female in my family to attend college, and I'd also like to tell you about an important first female today named Marilyn Brightful. She became the first black female to attend the Lansdowne YMCA at only 5 years old in 1957. She grew up right here in Yaden on Lincoln Avenue, and if it wasn't for these accomplishments by everyday people who go above and beyond to show their courage, we wouldn't be able to have the opportunities that we have today. Marilyn Brightful is now Marilyn Hill, and she's my mother-in-law. So we would love to hear from you.
Reminder to all scholars, ExactPath is crucial to your ability to learn and grow as an individual student. ExactPath is a digital program that identifies areas of needed growth for each individual person and then provides them with the practice key they need to improve in those areas.
Think of ExactPath like individual practice in sports. If you're trying to make the NBA, you would definitely have to go to team practices and work hard to train to get better. But you should also be working on your own, on the parts of your game that you struggle with as an individual. That's ExactPath. So remember, the time we have to work on ExactPath is important. Make sure you're taking advantage of it.
And now for my favorite part of Patriot News, Women History Month Facts of the Week. Did you know that until 1974, women were not allowed to have a credit card in their own name?
Are you serious?
No, I'm not kidding.
The Equal Credit Opportunity Act of 1974 prevents lenders from discriminating based on gender or marital status, among other things. Now we'll have the Women's History Month trivia questions provided by, well, you and Krista.
Who was the first female American poet whose poetry was published in London in 1650?
Oh, 1650 American poets.
That's a valid point. There was no America in 1660. We're gonna have to go back to the drawing board with that one.
Who introduced America to French cooking in her books and television series from 1963 through the
1990s? Oh, wait, I know this one. Julia Childs.
Who became the first female Secretary of State appointed by President Clinton in 1997?
Shirley Chisholm.
The first female, I don't know.
What woman has a total of 56 Grand Slam tennis competitions, events, and 9 Wimbledon women's single titles?
Serena Williams. It wasn't Venus?
It wasn't.
Oh, who was?
By a Stephanie Graf Stan. But I'm going to go with Martina Navratilova.
Fatimata. Here's an amazing woman named Ruby Bridges who had the power to bravely face adversity. And here's some interesting facts about her. The Children's Museum of Indianapolis created an exhibit that honors her, as well as other children such as Anne Frank, to highlight children who have made a difference. She created a foundation in her own name to promote tolerance and advocated for change through education. In November of 1960, she was the first African American to integrate into a Southern elementary school. And she received the Carter G. Woodson Book Award for her novel she wrote about her experiences. Here is another wonderful woman named Rosa Parks. She had the power to take a stand. And here are some interesting facts about her. She was the first woman in our nation's history to be buried with honor at the US Capitol. She received the Presidential Medal of Freedom, the highest civilian honor. She was an established leader of the civil rights movement in Alabama. And she is considered to have started one of the largest social movements in history, the Montgomery Bus Boycott. Now to Morgan.
Hello, Pooh Middle School, and as you already know, this month is Women's History Month. This month, we'll be highlighting and covering women of the defining categories such as the arts, sports, math, science, and politics, and so much more. This month, we'll be covering the dazzling topic of the arts. So get your jazz hands ready and your range expanded, and let's go into a world of not your imagination, but of women's history. And also, dear anime fans, I would stay tuned because there is a highlight just for you. My name is Dorothy Danbridge. I was born November 9th, 1922. I was an American actress, singer, and dancer. I am the first African-American film star to be nominated for the Academy Award for Best Actress, which was for my performance in Carmen Jones, 1954. I performed as a vocalist in Venus, such as the Cotton Club and the Apollo Theater. During my early career, I performed as part of the Wonder Children. Later, the Danbridge Sisters and I appeared in a succession of films, usually as uncredited roles. In 1959, I was nominated for the Golden Globe Award for Porgy and Bess. I am the subject of the 1999 HBO biographical film, Introducing Dorothy Danbridge. I have been recognized with a star on Hollywood Walk of Fame. I died September 8, 1965, under mysterious circumstances at the age of 42. Hello, Pivotal School. My name is Myrina Loy. I was born August 2nd, 1905. I was an American film, television, and stage actress. I was born in Helena, Montana. I was raised in Rose Raderberg during my early childhood before relocating to Los Angeles with my mother in my early adolescence. There, I began studying dance and trained extensively throughout my high school education. I trained as a dancer and devoted myself fully to an acting career, following a few minor roles in silent films. I was originally typecasted in exotic roles such as a vamp or a woman of Asian descent. But my acting prospects improved greatly following my portrayal of Nora Charles in The Thin Man, 1934. I also appeared in roles like The Rains Came, 1939, The Woman, 1973, which was my Broadway debut, and many others. With the outbreak of World War II, I all but abandoned my acting career to focus on the war efforts and began devoting my time working with the Red Cross. I was so fiercely outspoken about Adolf Hitler that my name appeared on his blacklist, resulting in my films being banned in Germany. Throughout the 1950s, I assumed an influential role as co-chairman of the Advisory Council of the National Committee Against Discrimination in Housing in 1948. I had become a member of the U.S. National Commission for the UNESCO. I was the first Hollywood celebrity to do so. I won many notable awards for my acting career. Some to be noted are Kennedy Center Honors in 1988, the Academy Honors in 1991, and many others. I died at age 88 on December 14, 1993 at Lonox Hill Hospital in Manhattan during a surgery following an unspecified illness. Subsequently, I was not able to attend the Academy Awards ceremony where I was to receive a Lifetime Achievement Oscars.